Williams the other day, Heisman voter, and he was very happy to see two running backs here. Last running back to win it was Ingram in 2009. You take a little pride of maybe a running back winning this year, bringing it back?
It's good to have two running backs here. I think the quarterbacks are dominated for the past couple of years. Ricky Williams, man, I look up to him, so I was happy to hear him say my name as a promise.
As a running back to be able to...
Yeah. He told me to always call on me to buy his team. Congratulated me on the boys out there, so it's like a good trip for me.
You know, obviously, the history of Alabama, the national championships, all the great players they've had. It's amazing that he's the only type of number that they've had.
Man, yeah, it is amazing because the tradition that and the players that came through there, I mean, it's just amazing how much praise had they ever had. He's the first one, but when he had a good season, we won the Heisman, so
is it amazing that you get to join that group?
Yeah. I'm trying to think that far. Just trying to enjoy it right now, but man, that would be pretty amazing to bring this other Heisman back right now.
Derek, are you at all concerned that NFL coaches might attach you to another Alabama back who played behind a great offensive line, Trent Richardson?
I'm not really worried about that. I'm worried about me in college. If I have the opinion, one thing I worry about is how I go out and work and how I play, so I don't even care.
To be able to break Bo Jackson, Herschel Walker, backs like that, to be able to break their records, how amazing is that for you to be able to do something like
that's
that?
That's a blessing, and I'm so thankful just to be mentioned and things like that. I mean, they both are legends. I'm not where they are right now. I feel like I got a lot to improve on, but it's an honor to be mentioned with those names.
Now, you know Bo Jackson has you as his favorite to win the Heisman. What's it mean to be able to have a guy like that to want you to win the award?
Yeah, I mean, it's like, I'm dreaming. You know, Bo Jackson is like the best athlete in the world when he was playing, one of the greatest that ever played with him. So it's an honor for me. It's like a dream come true for him to feel like that about me. So I'm just thankful.
A lot of running backs are students of the game. They watch running back tape, watch running backs from yesteryear, watching their tape, watching the way they run. Are there any running backs, past or present, that you formulate or emulate your game after?
I just got asked that question over there, but I can choose a list. I like Earl Campbell, Eric Dickerson, Walter Payton, Adrian Peterson, Eddie George. I can go on and on.
Why are running backs like that, where they can watch, where they want to watch the running backs from the 50s and 60s and 70s?
I mean, those guys are just physical. They dominated the game. It's a different breed. You don't see guys like that all the time. Like where they play, how they ran the ball, it's something you have to see. And I feel like it's something you can take a lot from.
Well, a lot of people, though, have focused on the enormous number of carries that you're getting and what it takes to carry 40 times a game. Can you explain, how difficult that is to just, pound the rock like that?
Yeah, difficult when you want the ball, when you want to make plays. I want to make plays, and that's what I want to do. I told Coach, I want the ball because I want to have a team win. As a running back, you got to have that mentality of saying that you're going to run the ball hard and be physical and finish your run. So that's my mentality. It ain't hard for me at all.
How was Nick Saban to play for?
It's just everything. He teaches you a lot. The standard he holds us to, we get better every day. He challenges us every day. So nothing comes easy. No excuses. Have great discipline. Prepare the right way. Practice how you want to play. That's what he teaches.
Derek, I read that you have a tattoo that says country. What's it like to be in the city in New York?
Say what?
Say country on it?
Oh, no, I don't know.
That's not you?
No.
Some people miscast you as being a power back, but when I watch you, I see a guy that could find the crease and has the acceleration to pull away from defenders. Can you talk about why you're more than just a power running back?
I'm not the type to brandle myself. Talk about my game, how the other people do that. But, I just go out there and do what I can coach. Just go out there and do what I do throughout the week. Just go try to make plays for my team. But I don't really like talking about myself.
Can you say what kind of speed you have in the 40?
Derek, you may be aware that the original Heisman sits under lock and key and never comes out to see the light of day. So you'll be getting a new one that's cast for each winner. Does it bother you that you won't be able to touch the original one?
No, not at all. I'm
your team prepares for
college playoff run.
How quickly do you have to get from there to get ready for Michigan State? Is that going to be a challenge?
Once I leave here, it's go time. You gotta get focused. You gotta go out there and go to work with my brothers and my teammates. So, I'm just locked in and get ready to play.
You talked to Deshaun about possibly meeting again in Arizona?
No, we haven't talked about it. Having fun.
Have you had a chance to look at any Michigan State tape? Because that's a pretty stout defense.
I haven't really watched much tape on it, but I know they are a tough team, got a good defense. The last four games, they were really tough team.
Were you surprised that Ohio State only gave it to Elliott 12 times when they played them?
I don't follow that at all. That's Ohio State.
Obviously, everybody here has great numbers. Everyone here has had a great season. Is it different when you're going just doing through the SEC and you know, like competition if you have to play in that league?
I mean, they have their confidence, but more confidence. But the SEC is a great conference, great teams. Good athletes, good players. So, we just have to bring it. So, anybody can beat you in the SEC, especially SEC West, is very tough. I should be better right away. So, we got to execute.
Is being here something that you had envisioned before this season?
I mean, I hope every college player that plays in my position is good. I wish to bring it here. You know, I knew that what I did throughout the week and what I was coaching, right there for my team.
Why do you think it's been so long since you've been on the Bucks?
Derek, being part of the playoff process last year, you think you can take anything from that to help you this time around?
Yeah, it definitely is. Because, you know, last year, really cold. We go in a different mindset, just playing the right way, staying like them, challenge each other, compete real hard, make sure we work hard, and get ready for that class.
From a player's perspective, how cool is it to be part of the first two college football playoffs?
It's very cool. You know, Coach Saban put us at a high level, so we can perform real well on the field. So, we just try to be successful every year as season goes on.
Do you like the format? Do you like the format for teams?
Has this season had a lot of pressure though, because you had that early loss to Ole Miss, so you guys had to be perfect after that? What was that like?
After that loss, we really didn't get down. We stayed locked in, and we knew that we had to win every game. So we knew every week we had to get better and better and challenge each other. You know what I'm saying? Just so we can win this one.
What does it mean to put your name right next to Herschel Walker and have Herschel Walker with you this year?
It's an honor. It's a blessing. No, I'm not, but I want to be commercial for this, but it's not a good one.
How often do you talk to TJ Yeldon? Do you guys talk a lot?
We talk from time to time. You know, TJ's the NFL. Yeah. He has a lot of stuff he has to do, so he reaches out to me and he has time all the time.
Yeah.
So you can figure what you're going to do while you're up here?
Enjoy the moment here. It's an honor to be here, so we'll have fun and do what they have for us.
You know a lot of teams. You know that because Alabama doesn't have such a strong passing game this year, I mean, they're just going to pound, put 8-9 guys in the box all the time. How tough is it to see that game after game after game?
I don't really care about what the defense is stacking the box, what's got to do, what I got to do, help my team win. Jacob Coker is a good quarterback, he can make throws. He's good in the passing game. We got better. We got better. So there's no doubt that's the best man. But we also want to be efficient.
Have you seen Deshaun or Christian play on TV much? What are your thoughts on them?
Great players. They do a great job for the team. Christian is very versatile. He can do a lot of things, with the ball. And Deshaun is a great quarterback. You know, that's a hard position. He's so consistent and efficient, really good, throwing the ball really well.
Thanks, Tim.